Okay. Here we go. Hey, yeah, now you can get down to the bedroom. Neat. Oh, this is where you were, and I didn't get to look at stuff. This desk is in pretty lousy shape on account of the guns piled on top of it. If you need to get any last-minute paperwork done, look elsewhere. Oh no, this desk is a serious case of covered in stupid guns. There's nothing you can do for it. It would immediately get lost among the alien gun boy clutter, and you have a feeling this thing might be important. Maybe. The desk is already kind of a gross mess. You're not sure buyers squawking like an idiot and taking a dump on it would improve matters. You hate to be crude, but there he is. He's a desk dumper. You could dump a bunch of spice into your equipment so that it doesn't work very well anymore. But that would be extremely childish. What are you, some kind of child? Nothing? It looks like some of the equipment already has bites taken out of it, so that might be redundant. Pogs don't work. The pile is already pretty toppled. You can't even call this a pile, really. More of a heap. Oh, I did that. Right. No room, it's covered in guns. You're not sure if that was a result of the portal beam, or if his desk just always looks like this. You see the medium book of beasts, the small book of beasts, and several beasts collected in random order in a book. None of the beast-centric tomes on these shelves offer you any insights on the sketchy diagram you found downstairs. Oh, can we get this thing again? No. Okay. You skim the shelves but don't see anything about pigeons. Maybe they don't have them on this planet? Or maybe you would need to actually open one of these books and look inside to find out. Well, that's that. You're not made of time here. You briefly muse on the anachronistic juxtaposition of a cluttered bookshelf, stuffed with papers, and a hover sled. Then you quit doing that and shake a leg because Xefros needs your help. You've already got a nice comprehensive book on leucises. You pick a page, yeah. And I did this. None of the beast-centric tomes on these shelves offer you any insights on this sketchy diagram you found downstairs. I think I did this. You're hungry, but you're not eat pictures of alien animals hungry. Now that one's new. In a fit of whimsy, you jam a pog between two dusty-looking books on a shelf. Won't that just blow someone's mind, assuming anyone ever returns here? There's a lot of animal care info on this pet bookshelf, but you think you've already mastered pet treat presentation. Not a single paper ruffled. Either you're losing your touch, or they're really jammed in there. You suppose there could be a lot to learn about dancing from studying the movements of alien beasts? You might acquire unique insight into the very soul of rhythmic movement by obsessing over the way an alien cat monster kills an alien snake monster. But you feel you must solidify your foundational skill set before you attempt this bold, exotic evolution. Oh, cool. See, we didn't see this stuff. These movies kind of look like not your thing, really. No judgment, you just don't want these posters at all. That's cool. Oh, I did that, right? And that's, yeah. Okay. That's that. You can step that way. The hover pad might be able to lift life this safe. It might not, but you don't have time to mess around with it right now. Xefros needs your help. It won't fit, and you don't have any plans to go back through that dangerous vent shaft. Even if you are lowered gently by the careful embrace of the hover pad, that doesn't really seem to be its style anyway. You could use your stethoscope to turn the dials and listen to the tumblers and the pins, and that's about all the safe-cracking terminology you can summon up at the moment. Oh, I did that. You already foolishly left one vet medkit behind. You're not about to dump this one down a vent shaft. Okay, so if you step this way... This is a dangerous path, but you can still manage, especially now that there's no guns and or drums on top of it. Let's go back to where I was. Oh, yeah, it does. Okay. So I guess I'll go through here. Where am I supposed to use the hovercraft thingy? The monitors are already kind of hovering. At least they're in the air. These must be Xefros' Lucis? Yeah, Lucis. That's Xefros' Lucis on the bottom monitor there. Doesn't look like it needs any medical treatment at the moment, which is, oof, probably more than you can say for Xefros. Okay, I think we might go out that way. So before I do that, I just want to peek in here. Still eating. He's calmed down a little. A sudden hovering might send him right back into that stoic rage from before. You would feel better about treating the deer cat if you knew a little more about it than nothing. Fortunately, you happen to snag some reading material on just that topic. All you need to do is consult it. Okay, I'll do that in a minute. You gotta go with the real thing. You missed. The real one's over there. Okay, can't interact here. You can't steal Demix TV. What's gotten into you? This alien bug world is a bad influence. It's staticky, but that's probably not... You mean, it's probably not, like, sick. It's probably not alive. It's almost definitely not an alive thing that needs your help. You abandon this line of speculation and return to Xefros. Oh, this thing. It seems to be floating pretty good on its own. It's too late. Once they reach the food stage, there's really nothing you can do. Demix's computer is the only non-filthy, non-cluttered, non-gun-bristling thing in his whole house. You can't be the one to ruin that. It's not sick, it's just off. Off is fine. You don't want to look at Demix's gross bug computer. Alright. Upon closer inspection, this animal is clearly hurt. It's time to put the resources you've gathered to their proper purpose. You flip through the pages. Let's see here. Here we go. Its scientific name is apparently the cuspidated grimalkin. The cuspidated grimalkin is a chimerical union of predator and prey with the strengths of both. Long retractable claws and razor sharp teeth alongside a defensive crown of stabbing horns. The speed for lightning-quick dashes and the endurance to run entire nights without tiring. Proud and resplendent, cuspidated grimalkin prefer to bond with bronze-blooded wigglers in whom they sense a strong natural aptitude for leadership. Such aspirations and low bloods are grounds for culling, of course, and the primary cause of death for cuspidated grimalkin is in the defense of their treasonous wards. Anecdotal accounts suggest that those cuspidated grimalkin who manage to survive the death of their wards will typically seek out a simile orphan troll and attempt to bond with them, although the selection process is, naturally, rather mysterious due to its staggering illegality. Several anatomical diagrams are included from these, you think you'll be able to treat the deer cat, which is what you're going to continue calling it for now. Cuspidated grimalkin is a bit of a mouthful. Yes, it is. Your appraisal of the patient is over. Demonstrate your newfound expertise by using your newfound instruments. Yeah, in a second. Anything else? You turn back to the cuspidated grimalkin section for a quick reread. Yeah, same. You could use it as a bandage. Doesn't seem like it would be very clean, though, since you found it on the floor of a dirty basement and then shoved it in your pocket with all of your other garbage. Byers might be able to pluck the thorn from the deercut's paw, that's what it is, and then they would be best friends, but maybe they'd get closer to each other than they are to you, and then start to exclude you from things. You've been burned before. Better to just pluck the thorn yourself. The deercat looks like he has a pretty sensitive sniffer. A snootful of this stuff might send him into a frenzy, or kill him outright. Who knows? Not you, that's for sure. Alien planet! The cardboard pox just don't afford the precision you'd need to help the injured beast. And if you used a slammer, well, heck, you might as well just kick its leg right off. It's already enjoying the milk. Better not mess with success. Oh, that's definitely going to get him all agitated again. You're light on your feet, but that would still hurt him. You think you'd rather try using your hands, preferably with some decent veterinary instruments in them. Okay, let's give it a try. Ow! Aw. Aw. Mmm. Huggy. Oh wow, what a cutie. But what's his name? You could ask Xefros, you guess. But you feel like there's something between the two of you now. Something that merits a new one. I'll keep it as Cornerbuster. Ride? Cornerbuster seems to be doing better. And so are you. You helped out an animal. An alien animal. This is a pretty big win for you, so you're riding high, despite the bizarre and frightening circumstances. And speaking of riding... Look at that graceful beauty of a friendly beast. Cornerbuster doesn't need any help getting around, especially now that you got their paw all fixed up. You already got that nasty thorn out and bandaged him up. Any further fussing with the wound would cause Cornerbuster more harm than good. You remember the tragic and smiley hilarious tale of President James Garfield, who Jude insists was assassinated by alien gangsters. He looked it up once, and in truth, he succumbed to nothing more sinister than a terminal case of extreme medical incompetence. Read about it again. You and the deer cat are pretty chill now, but it may be a little early to start introducing them to your other animal companions, especially considering they're a half-cat and Byers is an all-bird. That big sensitive snoot would probably sneeze this stuff right back into your face. It would be cute, but kind of a waste, and of course the spice mix might just kill Cornerbuster outright, like it did to that monster in your kitchen. Oh come on, you just got on his good side. Pogs. You're certainly tempted to give Cornerbuster a big handful of treats, but they did just have a bowl of milk, and you don't even know if treats from Earth are safe for big friendly deer cats from Alternia, right? It was Alternia. Anyway, treats can wait. Xefros needs your help. Oh, no. You don't want to startle them. You show your new pal Cornerbuster some of your best steps, and he seems suitably impressed. In retrospect, maybe he wasn't preparing to pounce on you those times you ran away from him before. Maybe he was just admiring your incredible grace and perhaps sensing a kindred spirit? Maybe. Ride? Now that I'm thinking about it, I'm suddenly pretty nervous about how I'm going to get over there. I keep seeing the shadows of huge, hulking things flying around outside. Yeah, the crossing won't be easy. I'm sorry. Is it always this hard to get across the street? No. I mean, not usually. Things got pretty... In excess? In excess? How do you mean? Somebody we were supposed to be meeting up with didn't show. Or maybe they did and it went bad. I really don't know. Demick didn't tell me what was happening. And I screwed everything up. I know it. You shouldn't stay there. I don't want you to risk getting hurt because of me. You're gonna risk it for me? Yeah, that's true, I guess. No guessing necessary. I didn't realize then how brave you were being. Thank you. It means a lot. But, no buts. Except yours, which I'm saving. Are you sure? Extremely. Oh, We'll be there in a flash. Excellent. Wait, we? Sweet. I got my trusty flashlight. Or whatever the hell she calls it. My strife weapon. Hello there. Hey, we're here. Oh jeez, is that you under the rubble? I mean, I assume it is. I hope so. Not that I want you to be getting crushed under rubble. I hope it didn't happen enough that I mistake you for someone else being crushed under rubble. No, it's me. I was lucky. Lucky? Left for dead, covered up, but not hurt bad enough to actually die. The ones who got cold on sight, or snatched up to be cold later, probably in some sick high blood spectacle, they weren't as lucky as me. This is what you're rebelling against? These drone things? No. I mean, not really. The heiress is in charge, and the drones obey her. It's her birthright. So why is she doing this? I have no idea. Low bloods get cold for anything and everything, or no reason at all. She doesn't have to have one. Or maybe our sub-grub being on fire makes a really sick selfie background. Are you serious? She sounds terrible. Yeah, no kidding. It's like the Tetrarch says. The slow, the soft, the unlucky, the troublemakers. Anyone who doesn't jump when the heiress snaps her webby little fingers. They get rounded up, enslaved, or slaughtered. Especially rustbloods. Like me. This is terrible. Your neighborhood is on fire. You're buried in rubble. Like you said, this is why we were rebelling. This is so awful. Why hasn't someone already put a stop to this? My subgrub is full of lowbloods. We don't matter. So nobody who does matter cares. All this is taking out the garbage. It's always been this way. Nobody does anything about it. Especially not gutterbloods. Shouldn't you guys talk after you get them out of there? Like me, we're mostly good at laying down to die. But you're rebelling, right? So are you doing something? Oh, that's not me. That's a Tetrarch. Tetrarch Domek is different. He's amazing. I wish you could meet him. He always does things like he's in a movie where he's the star, you know? He put the whole thing together. The Rebel Network, the plan, all of it. But without him, we don't have a chance. He was the one everyone talked to, and now he's gone. He's gone, and I'm alone. And I'm slow and soft and stupid. I'm just a nothing little gutter blood nobody. No. Caps. What? This Damek guy, he sounds like he stinks. What? Okay, I'm sorry, but you talk about him constantly, and not a single word you've said doesn't make him sound like an awful bully. No. It's not like that at all. He's just looking out for me. Ugh, open your eyes. Why do you think you're really saying these terrible things? It's like I don't know where you're coming from. Sometimes my pa just makes me feel just rotten. And I think, am I the reason he's never around? What's wrong with me that makes my own father not want to see me? But that's a load of garbage. The only person responsible for the terrible things he does is him. You don't understand. Me and the Tetrarch have been together since we were grubs. We were fated to be more rails. Well, that is. You wouldn't get it because you're an alien. I need him. No, you don't. I may not know anything about the social customs of this crazy alien planet, but I know that a real friend would never stand by and let you think and say those things about yourself. I don't think you're nothing. In fact, I know you're not nothing. You've got plenty of your own bravery. Just because fighting back was his idea doesn't mean it didn't take courage to see it through. And you were going to risk everything to save me, an alien you'd never even met. That's the bravest thing I've ever heard get tried. Do you really think so? Yeah. I believe in you, Xefros. Wow. You remember my name this time. It's not the first time. This is like the second or third time. Yes. That's because you made such a big impression on me, and were such good friends that I'd be really sad if you gave up and died here under these rocks. Oh, man. That actually means a lot to me. I'd never even dreamed that something like this would happen for someone like me. Xefros? I'm going to do my absolute best to raise your standard of friendship to the point where having your name remembered is not the nicest thing anyone has ever done for you. I'm not alone after all. I've got Joey Alien here to save me. and tell me what to do. Well, no, we're in this together. Oh yeah, right. Thanks, Joey. Now let's get you out of here and then figure out what's next. Are you sure you don't know anyone who can help us? I kind of don't even know what kind of help we need, but it seems we do. Well, I do know someone, but they don't exactly live nearby. It'll be a journey. Are you sure they'll help us? Oh yeah, she hates the heiress. And she's our biggest fan. That's good enough for me. Now hold still, I'm gonna get you out of there. Okay. Corner Buster is looking antsy. Good instincts. You better finish up here quick. You can't leave without Xefros. Even if it didn't need your help, where would you go? Oh no, that must be Xefros. Yeah, wow, he wasn't kidding. That debris looks heavy. You hope he's okay, or at least that he will be. You better hurry up and help him out. This is Xefros' dad, apparently. He's moving pretty sloth-like, huh? Can't look at the houses and stuff. What does it say about incompetence? Oh, yeah. You consider giving the sloth the hover pad and letting him activate it to free Xefros. After all, he started the job, you guess, barely, but you don't have all day here, so maybe you should do it yourself. He looks plenty healthy, but very worried about Xefros. Aww. According to the book, the sloth Lucis is actually named the Glacial Tree Trudger. Wow, you learn something new every day. You're sorry to be blunt, but you're nervous he'd eat it. Actually, you're not that sorry. You don't need to tiptoe around someone's feelings just because they might do something rude. The sloth equips the pigeon helm, gaining the Trash Bird Barbuda ability, which is to say Byers lands on the sloth's head and poops on its neck. Fantastic. You aren't sure if making Xefros' pet more delicious is the best opening salvo of your in-person friendship. You mean that sincerely. For all you know, that might be step 17 of the alien friendship ritual. You think you'll play it safe, though. From the looks of him, this big bruiser lacks the lightning-quick mental acuity to keep up with the razzle-dazzle Pog's lifestyle. Just from looking at this big fella, you can tell he prefers his own brand of sloth treats. You're very perceptive about these things. The molasses-paced marsupial is unable to perceive your lightning-quick hot-stepping. You are just as certain of it as you are that sloths are marsupials. Your careful, graceful movements seem to resonate with the languid beast. You think. Now, I think we're supposed to use the hovercraft on this. You've got no chance of moving all that with your bare hands. It's time to bust out the hover pad. Or was it maybe the hover sled? You can't quite remember. Okay, I just want to see all the responses here. Xefros might need medical attention, but it would be a lot easier to treat him if he weren't currently being crushed by a pile of rubble. You also probably shouldn't use the vet med kit to do it. Just a thought for you, from you. Alright. You two can pour over this thing just as soon as Xefros can actually see it. That is to say, as soon as you get all the heavy debris off of his head and the rest of his body. Oh yeah, I just noticed his little hand sticking out. Byers is too weak, the sloth is too slow. Luckily, you have advanced alien technology at your disposal to help you solve this advanced alien rock injury puzzle. He's probably having enough trouble breathing as it is. Xefros already got slammed pretty badly. You don't want to add insult to injury. You actually need that sloth to back up a bit so you can use the hover pad, but he'll probably do that on his own. Jostling that rubble around is likely to just hurt Xefros worse. You need something with a little more kick? Ironic, considering dancing is not actually the solution here. You're very graceful, but you never would have made it across on your own. Okay, let's do it. Yay! Put me down. You okay there, buddy? We go for a ride? Aw. It's cute. Flirting. So we're going to his friends, this female's house? I thought there were only two females. Selfie! Oh, there's something behind us? Coming? I love the animation, so awesome. It's a Reaper! No. The heiress, I presume? Texting? Oh, she's so selfie too. I gotta admit, her eye makeup is on fleek. Cool. I can't believe it, guys. Act 1, Kansas City Shuffle. Okay. So it took me about 10 hours to play a 2-hour game. Hope someone out there enjoyed it. Maybe. I enjoyed it. I like reading and stuff, but my god, it was getting to me after a while. Especially once we get to this section. I couldn't really relate to the stuff. It was interesting to read about the lore of this world. Alternia? Cool name. I like it. Like alternative, Eternia, kind of. Mashup of words. So, I guess the future episodes are going to be, you know, we're still playing Joey, and sometimes this guy, Xefros, and trying to help him on this world, I guess? I'm not sure, maybe we might not get back until the end of the game. And then the other game, which I believe is called will be called Haunt Switch, features his friend. I use that in quotes because he does sound like a jerk. On Earth. But the funny thing is, what are those monsters? Where do those monsters come from? Did they come from this world as well? Did they swap over as well? Swap from Hiveswap? Toby Fox, there he is. So let me know what you guys think. Let me know what you think of the game. And, he has so much lengthy descriptions for almost everything. And using everything with everything. It's insane. I'd like to know the word count for this game. Kickstarter. That's right, it was a Kickstarter project. I forgot about that. Breitbart sounds familiar. These are all the backers? Guess so. Well, thanks for watching, and whenever they come up with Hiveswap Act 2, I'll be playing it. I'm thinking it might not be for a few months. It might take a while. But thanks for watching. And does anything happen now? No. Okay, guys. See you in another Let's Play, or see you in Hiveswap Act 2. Wherever you choose to join me, you are most welcome. And as always, always seek adventure.